Hi everyone, my name is Keanu and I'm on the product team at Appian. And today's video topic is going to be asynchronous loading or loading data in the background of your user interfaces. A lot of times when we're developing applications, we have to wait for the slowest pull in the tent, so to speak. And when that happens, there's really no way around it. And users end up staring at a blue loading bar for a long time until everything's ready, and then their page shows up. Well, asynchronous loading is intended specifically to help with that situation. When you have a slower third-party integration or slow query that you have to wait for, but you shouldn't have to wait for the entire page to finish before you get to interact with the page and see where you want to go next. So with asynchronous loading, some of that data is going to be able to be loaded in the background, and I'm going to show you an example of how to use asynchronous loading in your applications using the brand new abang async variable function in Appian. This new function is available in 25.3, so if you upgrade to the latest, you'll be able to use it right away. Okay, so here's my application that I'm going to use for this demo. This is just using some simple interface patterns, and this is a dashboard interface that has some of my experiment data, proposals, and cases on display. I'm going to go ahead and refresh this page, and as soon as I do that, we'll see that it takes quite a while to load, and I'm stuck looking at that loading bar until everything finishes. Well, there we go. I've got the whole page loaded, and now I can interact with the page and see the rest of everything on the screen. So how do I go about finding out what is slow on this page? First, I'm going to go to the site. And from here, I'm going to find the page that I was just looking at and open that up in Interface Designer. I already have that open here. And once we're in Interface Designer, I'm going to go ahead and open up the Performance Details view to try and diagnose what's slow on the page. I'll hit the test button so I can see the latest definition of my interface and wait for that to finish. Okay, once that has shown up, I can see that my page takes about 9 seconds to load. And in order to find out what I should try to load in the background, I'm just going to drill down and look for the thing that's taking the longest amount of time, or usually when I do this, I'm looking for the highest percentage. So here it looks like at this level, it's starting to break down by different local variables on my interface. All right, great. Local bank top five accounts for 56% of the load time of my interface. So I'm gonna want to put that local variable and have it load its data in the background. I'm also taking note here that there's another local variable, unique account names, that takes 5 seconds, but it looks like these are tied to the same data because they're taking the exact same amount of time. Local bang cases open more than 5 days is another one that I'm going to want to take a look at, so I'm going to keep that one and write it down for later. The rest of the evaluation time, it looks like it's happening in the body, and I'm not really sure if it's happening here or somewhere else yet. But let's go ahead and address what I've already seen so far, and we'll take it from there. So I'm going to close the performance details page. And then I'm going to head over to expression mode, because that's how I can use the new abang async variable function. All right, I'm going to search for one of those local variables that I had earlier. Great, okay, I found a local variable that I saw was taking 5 seconds to load, and it's calling a query rule or some sort of integration function. And so what I'm gonna do to try and make the page speed up is wrap this in abang async variable. Now in this case, the thing that I think was slow, it's probably inside of this rule, but that doesn't really matter for me at this point because I'm only interested in making this UI fast. If the thing that is slow inside of that is reused elsewhere, I can also apply this to those UIs Or I can consider looking inside of that and making part of it load in the background instead of the whole thing. Now here, I've just wrapped my data inside of abang async variable within abang local variables. Great. That's all I have to do. Now I know that this data, if it's slow, it's going to load asynchronously, so the rest of the page can load around it. I'm going to go ahead and apply the same thing to the other local variable that I already found was slow on the page. So now I have two things loading asynchronously. I'm going to hit test so we can see what that's looking like. All right, still takes a while to load, but I can see that now I can interact with the page faster and I get spinner animations on these charts that were using those local variables. Great. That's exactly where I want to be, and I'm already making my page faster. Let's look at the performance details to confirm. All right, it looks like the part that I was looking at is now responsible for 1% of the loading time, and something else on the page is taking a while. So let's try and find what that is. I'm going to use the same method that I used before to find what is slow on this page. And okay, it looks like I've got a parameter to a plugin function that I'm going to go ahead and look for now. Google Geo chart field. All right, wonderful. So I'm going to see that the chart row data is taking almost 3 seconds to load. And here, this time, my query is not happening inside of a local variable already. So I'm going to want to move it to a local variable. That way I can use abang async variable just like I did before. All right, so here I'm going to copy in that and I'm going to turn it into a local variable. And I'm going to call that local bang chart data. So in my chart data itself, I'm going to use local bang chart data. And we'll see that when I define local bang chart data, I'm using abang async variable again. And just sticking the query rule or the slow integration here inside of abang async variable. And you'll notice something else. I'm able to use refresh behavior if I need, just like if I were using an abang refresh variable. This is nice because it means I don't have to choose between having nice refresh behavior when I'm using the page or having a fast UI with data loading in the background. I can use them both using abang async variable. All right, let's take a look at how it's doing. I'm going to hit test again. And now everything seems to be loading in a spinner straight away. As soon as the data loads in, or as soon as the data is ready, it loads in onto the page. And let's go ahead and see how it looks in our site. I'll save here. Head back to the site from before and refresh the page. All right, great. The page loads a lot faster now. And it looks like as things are ready, they're loading in. I'll refresh one more time so you can see how that worked. As soon as data is ready, like this data here that wasn't slow, it loads in the page, and I can still interact with the rest of the page as the charts and the component plugin load in the background. Perfect. That wasn't so hard, and that's just one of the ways that you can use asynchronous or background data in Appian. You can use abang async variable, which is new in 25.3, or you can use the load data async parameter that already exists on things like bar charts, grids, and KPI components. Those have been available for a while now, but now you'll find it a lot easier to reuse some of the data that's used throughout your interface using abang async variable. So let's just take a look at the documentation really quick. I wanted to show you just how data loading in the background works. And if you want to check this out for yourself, go to the docs and look for the asynchronous loading page in the documentation. So here is the example before we use asynchronous. The slowest part of your page is going to be the full load time of the page. As your page evaluates, it needs to wait for everything to finish and then the entire page is displayed to the user. When we incorporate asynchronous loading, here's an example using two asynchronous components. Once everything that's non-asynchronous finishes, the user will see the parts of the page that are available. When the first asynchronous data finishes, the page reevaluates and the user sees everything that's ready so far. And when the last piece finishes, the user will see everything on the page and can interact just like normal. So hopefully this is a tool that you're going to be able to use to make your interfaces feel a bit snappier and so that your users can find what they need on the page and get a better user experience using Appian. All right, that's all I wanted to show you today. Of course, if this video helped you out, please consider giving it a like so that other people can see it, and subscribe to get notified when our next video comes out so that you can stay on top of our UI performance topic and other Appian topics on the Appian Community channel. If you want to learn more, check out our documentation, but you can also check out our training videos and some of our courses on interface performance. The links for those will stick into the description. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.